In my last hosting review that dates almost a year back now, I mentioned that they offer low prices, great performance, and the service was generally unknown, so there was plenty of server space. But since that review came out, they kind of f***ing exploded. But you know what they say, more money, more problems. So here's what I think of Hostinger in 2020, here's what changed, and here's what you should know before you buy Hostinger. Let's get into the biggest selling point of Hostinger, their price. They are by far the cheapest web hosting provider out there, with plans starting in under a dollar. So for a 4-year web hosting plan, you'll only need to pay $43. Here's a chart comparing this to other major web hosting providers and their cheapest plans. But question is, what are the differences between the differently priced plans? And does more money equal more better? Well, I currently have all 4 plans and 2 virtual private servers with Hostinger, and here's what I think. So I mostly recommend this to people who are going to host photography websites, portfolio websites, or maybe a small business site. Basically something that gets a small amount of users once in a while, and for $43 you'll have your website up and running for 4 years. In general, I would stay away from the premium plan. Not because it's bad, but just by spending $1 more and getting the business plan straight away, you'll get around 15-20% better performance and daily backups, which separately cost $1 a month. So for the same price, you're getting 15-20% better performance. It's just better value for your money. Finally, the cloud hosting plan is top of the line performance that I normally only recommend for e-commerce or people opening up news websites, because for a regular website, it's a bit of an overkill. Basically, cloud hosting is best fitted for something that either generates money for you or has some serious traffic. I don't recommend you start out with this, and you can always upgrade or move into this. The only exception would be if you're moving from another web hosting provider with an already established project that's generating money or has some serious traffic, then don't even look at shared hosting, get the cloud hosting plan right away or you will run into issues. And as always, I want to let you know that the links down below are actually affiliate links, meaning if you buy anything through them, I'll make a commission. These videos take me weeks to properly test, research, buy the plans, edit the videos, and upload for you to watch. So I greatly appreciate if you want to support the channel and get yourself a special 10% extra discount on any web hosting plan with Hostinger, you use the links down below. Thank you for your understanding, and let's get back to this Hostinger review. Cloud hosting will cost you around $320 for a 4-year plan. The reason it's so expensive is because it uses different technologies, and you won't be sharing resources with other users on your server. You'll have your own separate space, so it's faster, more reliable, and just more secure in general. Okay, so let's assume you bought a plan from Hostinger and you're ready to get started. Let's see what they're packing under the hood and what you get right out of the box. The Hostinger user interface is quite fast and simple to navigate for beginners. For example, you can create a website automatically from scratch by clicking on Manage next to your plan, navigating to Auto Installers, and choosing one of the options. They offer more than WordPress. For example, you can choose PHP BB if you're creating a forum, or OpenCart if you're making an e-commerce store. There's plenty of options for different kinds of sites. To install this software, you simply click on it, choose the settings that you want, and click install. After some time, boom, your website is online on the internet and you can work on design, content, and stuff like that. Pretty much everything you need is located in the Hostinger control panel. For example, you can also create a custom email address by navigating to the email section, and in seconds you'll have a custom email box using your website name. Pretty neat. And of course, you still have all of the standard features like File Manager, Database Manager, and one of the newest additions that only got added in 2020 is the Website Dashboard function, where you can manage your website backups, plugins, updates, or activate a maintenance mode. While it's on, users will see that your site is being updated. And you can do all of this without even logging in into your WordPress site. Obviously, a review wouldn't be a review if I didn't show you the performance side of things. So for this Hostinger review, I actually want to do 3 separate tests, which is speed, stability, and the ability to handle stress. Since I don't have like 50 or 100 people ready at standby to crash my website, I'm gonna use virtual users. So I've quickly made a website that looks like this. It has plenty of text, buttons, pictures, videos, basically everything you would expect from an actual website, so this will give us more accurate test results. I've used GT Metrics and the test website loaded in 1.9 seconds, which is a really, really good result. Keep in mind that I am using the premium plan here for the test to have a nice middle point between the starter and the more expensive plans that Hostinger offers, so your mileage will vary. And obviously, I understand that if you don't deal with web hosting every single day, these figures are absolutely meaningless to you. But to put it into perspective, other speed-focused web hosting companies like A2 Hosting or SiteGround that also have really fast technology load the exact same website at the exact same speed using plans that cost 3 times as much. So for the same performance, you're paying 3 times less. What? Okay, but this was just a one-off test. There's absolutely no users on my website right now, and the more users you have on your website, the slower it will load. So I want to see the limit. How many people at the same time can we have on our website without it slowing down? Okay, so here's the deal. I've sent 50 virtual users to wreak havoc on my website, clicking and browsing and pushing all of those buttons, like, you know, casual stupid user stuff, to see if there's a difference in loading times when there's 50 people on my website versus when there's 0. It took me like 5 or 6 minutes, but I finished the test and it seems I was close to hitting the limit of my plan with 50 users on at the same time. So you can expect the best performance from the premium plan with around 40 users at the same time. If you go above 50, performance will start to drop. 50 users doesn't seem all that much in terms of web hosting. After all, you want hundreds, maybe thousands, probably hundreds of thousands of users, not 50. But keep in mind that we're testing 50 users at the same time, so it's different. I've actually ran websites that had thousands of visits, but rarely did I go above 30 people at the same time. Because each second someone leaves, someone new comes in, so 40 people at the same time is actually a pretty good deal for $3 a month. I would say it's roughly in the ballpark of like 100,000 users per month. If you're enjoying the video up to this point, consider hitting the like and subscribe buttons and help me please the YouTube algorithm gods. I do a lot of web hosting related stuff on my channel, and just recently I did a video called The Best WordPress Hosting, where I try to find out what makes WordPress hosting plans fast, how are one provider different from other, and stuff like that. And during my research for that video, I've noticed that Hostinger is actually using some of the newest technologies available, like Google Cloud Infrastructure, PHP 7.4, and Lightspeed. So that's pretty much how they guarantee the speed. They use the latest technologies that are on par with even the most expensive web hosting providers. But how are they able to do it for such a low price? No idea. As you can see right here, these are the statistics for 1 year. My website was offline for 3 hours out of the 8,760 hours that make up a full year, scoring Hostinger a 99.93% uptime. In terms of support, there was a huge shift coming from 2019 into 2020. And not all for the best. A lot of changes were made, and in my previous review, I've mentioned how Hostinger support is always fast, responsive, available to everyone, you got like 24/7 chat. Well, now it depends. The 24/7 chat support that was previously available to everyone is an email-based support system at the moment of recording this video. If you want 24/7 chat, you'll need to buy that as a priority support feature that does unfortunately cost extra. I've actually got an answer to this question via email in like 20 minutes, and one of the Hostinger agents explained that this is done basically due to the current events that are going on in the world right now. So it seems like this is a temporary fix, and 24/7 chat support for free will be back for everyone once we go back to normal. By the way, always rate your support agents. Realistically, I understand their decision. It's always better to provide good quality support to a smaller group of people than to provide poo-poo pee-pee support to a lot of people. But probably in the future, when you're watching this video, the support is already back to being 24/7 and free for everyone. And if you decide to go with the priority support option, you can choose for how long you want this feature to be available on your account. Most likely 1 month is enough to work out through everything you want, and then your site will be operating smoothly. The interactions are really smooth as well. You can send pictures, you can send gifts, and the general consensus that Hostinger support agents are actually really helpful and go above and beyond to solve your problems. One feature that didn't go away in 2020 is their knowledge base. You can still get access to their knowledge base for free. It has tons of pictures, most common problem fixes, and extensive articles that can help you solve the problems yourself. A really big advantage that often gets overlooked is that you get to decide where the physical location of your servers actually are, meaning you know which continent your files are being stored on when you're first setting up your website. Hostinger has data centers in the US, Europe, and Asia. So if you know that your users will be from the United States, choose the US data centers. If you expect people from Europe, choose the European data centers. Well, you get the idea. But what I mean by this is that not every single web hosting company lets you choose the data servers. So having the physical location chosen by you allows you to get a better performance for your users. And obviously, no company or service is without flaws. Obviously, Hostinger can't escape this as well. And not offering 24/7 chat support for free at the moment is sadly one of them. Other notable annoyance is that every single element in the control panel seems to load separately, and the loading time for some elements are quite high. So be prepared to see these loading bars quite a lot when navigating your panel. Moving on, they still have their weekly sales. These sales happen every week, and every week they're different. Some weeks you get an SSL for free, other weeks you get a domain for free. Well, you get the point. I wish they would just let you choose which kind of service you want for free without having to wait for these weekly sales and for the timer to run down. But it is what it is. So, I've been using Hostinger for quite a long time now, I would say like years. And other than these small things, I haven't really noticed anything that grinds my gears. The service, on average, for the price that I'm paying, is really good. And by the way, there's actually a way you can get an SSL certificate for free. Anyways, I'll leave a guide for that at the top right now. In my opinion, Hostinger is still one of the best choices for web hosting in 2020. And there's actually a reason why they grew so fast. Their prices are extremely low, the performance is better than ever, and they give you plenty of features to manage your site, and they keep adding more. And they finally added an option for high-end websites through their cloud hosting plans. Now, truly everyone can find what they need in terms of hosting for the fraction of the cost, no matter if you're hosting a portfolio or a highly important online store. I hope that in 2021, they'll continue to be as creative and as innovative as they've continued to be up to this point, offering the best possible technology for the lowest possible price. No idea how that works. But hey, I'm happy that they're here, I'm happy that they're offering great web hosting services, and if you're happy with this review, consider dropping a like and subscribe to my channel. This really helps me out as a content creator and helps me please the YouTube algorithm gods and make them like my channel. I wish you luck creating your websites, and I'll see you in the next video.